Okay, guys, we're back with My Job History. I believe this is number 5, maybe 6. Anyway, it'll be in the title. Anyway, so I told you at the end of the last video that the next one would be billiards. And as a lot of you know, I played billiards through the 90s. Played professionally. I was ranked number 1 here in Shizuoka for the longest time. I've been to the All Japan Championships quite a few times. So I got a job working at a pool hall. And basically, I worked from 1 to 7. And then when I was finished there, I would go to another pool hall, and that's where I would play. I never really played at the place where I worked. I don't know why. I think it's just because I, you know, really didn't like the people that played there. But anyway, I worked there for a number of years. My job basically consisted of, you know, running the register, taking care of customers, cleaning the place up, cleaning the tables. Yeah, I mean, it was an all right job. It was, you know, it paid the bills. I had some friends that would come in and we'd, you know, play during the afternoon. So, yeah, I did play there occasionally, but not in my free time. So, anyway, the guy that one a really interesting story from that time, the guy that owned the place wanted to go to Las Vegas for a billiards convention every year. There's this really big convention in Las Vegas where you can buy cues and goods and all kinds of stuff. And so we were able to get passes to get into the show from one of our distributors. So he really wanted to go. And he's like, Jim, let's go. And I was okay. And he says, I don't have a passport. And I said, well, you need to get a passport. Now, this was January, and the expo wasn't until July. So we, you know, 6 months, no problem. Plenty of time to get your passport. So, you know, February rolls around. I asked him, hey, Yamamoto-san. His name was Yamamoto. I said, Yamamoto-san, did you get your passport? And he said, no. I said, okay, well, we still got time. Now, I'm the type of person that if I'm traveling, I want everything to be point A to point B. That's it. No troubles, anything like that. I just want to get through it. So this was, still had plenty of time, but it started to burn on me just a little bit. So March rolls around. I asked him, Yamamoto-san, did you get your passport? And he says, no, not yet. And I'm like, oh my God. So April, not yet. May, not yet. June, he still hasn't gotten his passport. Now, we're leaving in 1 month. We're supposed to leave on July 11th. I remember the date. At the end of June, he told me that he sent his... I'm sorry. That's not how it happened. He was going to send in his application for a passport. So he got his passport, and it came in, and I went over to the pool hall to take a look at it, and when he handed it to me, it was North Korea. So he was born here, his parents were here, but he's got a North Korean passport. Now, North Koreans just don't walk into America and get a 30-day or 3-month or whatever visa. They have to apply for a visa first. Now, we've got 2 weeks until we leave, because this was like July 1st. And now I'm in panic mode. Oh my God, what the hell did this guy do? So I wrote a letter to the embassy that he could take with him. He said he would take the passport up himself the next day and submit it to get his visa. So I wrote a letter explaining the situation, what happened, blah, 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 blah. And if they could kind of hurry that up, you know, we'd be forever in their debt. Not that they would care. So anyway, I gave him the letter and off he went. The Friday before we were supposed to leave, this is 2 weeks after I wrote the letter, he calls me and he said that his visa was approved and he's good to go. I finally have some relief, okay? Like, I've been stressing over this for 6 months. Now, we're free to go. This is Friday, Saturday, Sunday, so 4 days before. So, I go to the pool hall to check out his visa, and he tells me that he forgot to give them a return envelope to send his passport back. Now, this is Friday, okay? The embassy's not open on Saturday and Sunday. So I told him, I said, you have to go up there on Monday and pick up your passport. And he said he couldn't because he had to work. Now I'm in full stress mode again. I'm ready to just keel over. So he said that he would go up on Tuesday morning, early in the morning. He'd be there when they open. Our flight didn't leave till like 2 or 3, 4 in the afternoon. So he would go up in the morning, pick up his passport, and then meet us at the airport. All right, like that's going to work. So, there's nothing I could do. Just, you know, I tried my best to not think about it. So that Sunday, 2 days before we leave, the pool hall, we had a barbecue down at the river. Now, I didn't attend, but about 2 o'clock in the afternoon, I get a phone call that Yamamoto-san had died. Yeah. They started the barbecue in the morning around 10 o'clock, and they said around noon or 1 o'clock, he wasn't feeling well, so he went and they had like a tarp on the ground. So he went over and laid down on the tarp, and somebody noticed that he hadn't been moving for a while, so they thought he was sleeping. They went to wake him up, and he was dead. Yeah, he'd had a heart attack. 2 days before he was supposed to leave. And we're focused on, oh my God, he died. But on the other hand, we had like $50,000 worth of business that we were going to be doing in Las Vegas. So what do we do about this? So I called on Monday to try to cancel our flights and everything and all that. And the airline wouldn't cancel the flight. They wouldn't give any money back. So now, along with the trip to Las Vegas, I was planning to go home afterwards and spend a couple weeks back in Cincinnati. So they, you know, we'd do our week in Vegas. They would go back to Japan. I would go to the Cincinnati. So I still had that part of my trip left. And so I really couldn't cancel. So there was a group of us, and I canceled I checked with all the other guys. Everybody else canceled. They told me to go on and, you know, do my thing. So I had like 4 days in Vegas on my own, with his death hanging over me. So it was my first time in Vegas. And needless to say, I didn't have a good time on that trip. Then I went home for a couple weeks, and then I came back here. But, you know, the thought of him, you know, all that stuff that went on, and then he died 2 days before he was supposed to leave. I mean, I was just like, oh, and he was only like 51 years old. He was really young. So, yeah, that was a mess. That was a real mess. And what if that had happened while we were on the flight, or if we were in Las Vegas? We were fortunate that it happened here. You know, obviously unfortunate that he passed away. But the night before I left, I had to go to his layout and, say my goodbyes. Yeah, life in Japan. So, you hear all these stories, you know, all the good things that happen in Japan, you know, bad things happen too. And that was one of them. Yeah, when I came back, the pool hall lasted about another 6 months, and they finally closed it down. His wife wasn't up to keeping it open, which is understandable. I don't need it. It may not even gone 6 months. And then, of course, there was a rush of trying to collect money from the people that had bought things at the pool hall, you know, like pool cues and stuff like that, trying to get them, you know, the people to pay up their bills. And I don't think that worked out for her either. But, yeah. Anyway, so that was my... That was my time at the pool hall, and so next time we'll move on from that. All right, guys, I'd also like to remind you guys the Big Paul's Big Nuts t-shirts right there. $20 at teespring.com/Big Paul's Big Nuts. We have 10 days left. We've got 9 orders. We have to sell 30. So if you guys could jump in there and get a shirt, it'd be really cool. I'd really, really appreciate it. And if you can't, I understand. So anyway, guys, thanks for that, and we'll talk to you later. Don't let your meat loaf.